data analysis libraries comparison. Pandas versus NumPy versus Polars versus Dask. Welcome.
Hey, I've been working with data analysis in Python, and I'm a bit overwhelmed by all the options. Could you help me understand the differences between Pandas, NumPy, Polars, and Dask?
Yeah. Let's break this down systematically. What's your current experience with these libraries?
I mainly use Pandas for my day-to-day work, but I keep hearing about performance issues with larger datasets. That's what got me interested in the alternatives.
Perfect starting point. Let's begin with NumPy, since it's actually the foundation that Pandas is built upon. NumPy is all about homogeneous arrays, meaning all elements must be of the same type. Here's a quick example.
I see. But why would I use NumPy when Pandas seems more feature-rich?
Good question. NumPy is ideal for mathematical operations and scientific computing. It's much more memory efficient than Pandas because it doesn't carry the overhead of indexes, column names, and mixed data types. If you're doing heavy numerical computations, especially with matrices, NumPy is your best friend.
What about Pandas then? When should I stick with it?
Pandas shines when you need to work with tabular data that has mixed data types, missing values, named columns, complex indexing. Here's a typical Pandas use case.
I've heard Polars is much faster than Pandas. Is that true?
Yes. Polars is a modern alternative to Pandas, written in Rust. It's designed for high performance and memory efficiency. It's particularly good at parallel processing, handling large datasets, memory-efficient operations. Here's a Polars example.
What about Dask? When would I need that?
Dask is your go-to when you're dealing with datasets larger than memory or need distributed computing. It's like Pandas, but for big data. The cool thing about Dask is that it uses familiar Pandas-like syntax.
So if I had to choose one, how would I decide?
Here's my rule of thumb. Use NumPy for pure numerical computations and scientific computing. Stick with Pandas for everyday data analysis with datasets that fit in memory. Switch to Polars when you need better performance, but still want a Pandas-like interface. Choose Dask when your data is too large to fit in memory or you need distributed processing.
This is super helpful. One last question, can these libraries work together?
Absolutely. That's one of the best things about the Python ecosystem. You can easily convert between them.
Thanks. This really clarifies when to use each library.
Happy to help. Remember, there's no one-size-fits-all solution. You may, for example, consider data size, computation requirements, and whether you need distributed processing.